I think the human rights reports have grown into something unique and remarkable. They are actually, amazingly, the only comprehensive human rights report that covers the entire world, every single country, and every important human rights issue put out by any entity anywhere. No human rights group puts out a global report as comprehensive as the State Department does, no other government, to my knowledge, does.
Beginning in 1979, we started to do an annual critique of the country reports, where we would read the reports carefully and comment on their objectivity, looking in particular for any signs of political editing. For the United States government to put forward its judgment, its fact-finding about what's happening on the ground in all of these countries, it means that governments have to listen. Doesn't mean they like it, doesn't mean they don't try to dismiss it, but it's meaningful.
By doing the reports, it forces all the people in the State Department to have to analyze what's going on in these countries. And with analyzing what's going on in these countries, hopefully it will spill over to policy. Now, if I was going to recommend, the next step is to make sure that the assessments of what's happening in the countries translates into policy towards other countries. Part of the strategy of a dictatorship, an authoritarian regime, is to isolate those people that are opposing the regime. And they are made to feel, human rights defenders or democratic activists are made to feel that no one knows what's happening to them. They're completely isolated. By assessing what's happening within the countries, you are shining a spotlight on the abuses, and you're empowering those defenders and making them feel less alone. And that's an incredibly important gift and contribution that an outside actor can play for those people that are really doing the hard work on the front lines.
This report delivered a direct message to the Burmese military, Honda, and other authoritarian regions. That means that the United States is watching very carefully about the human rights violations against their own citizens. Also, one day they will be accountable for their human rights abuses. So this is a very strong message to the authoritarian regions like my country.
Well, Iran is a human rights disaster at the moment. We have scores of people who have been murdered by the government. We have thousands of people who have been arrested. We have many, many hundreds of cases of really appalling torture and sexual abuse in prisons. And drawing attention to those abuses and stopping them is absolutely critical. You know, Iran is a problem in many fields, in the nuclear field, in terms of terrorism, in terms of its threats to other UN member states. But at the core of this problem is a regime that tramples upon human rights, and anything anybody can do to draw attention to those human rights abuses is incredibly valuable. The people of Iran are amazingly brave. They've taken on a regime that other people are scared of, and I think by documenting those abuses, drawing attention to them and calling for change, we are showing a very minimal and very important level of solidarity.
The reports speak in the voice of the U.S. government. And state facts, because that is their value. Obviously, no government likes to be criticized. But it's very important in terms of setting foreign policy and making decisions about aid, and really to help the government come up with its game plan, its objectives with respect to human rights in all of these countries.